Greece, Israel and Italy on the Fantasia. My Travels, Neil Walker. Hello, travelling by air to Nice, then rode to Genoa, the beautiful MSC Fantasia awaited us. The start of a new adventure. First stop, Katakalon, Greece for Olympia. I love the sign, soon to be doubts if it's 33 or 38 kilometres. We had a short stroll before setting off for Olympia. A pleasant drive. Unfortunately, we would only see Olympia from afar, as it was closed due to a strike. Our guide, however, did a good job with lots of pictures and information as we looked over the fence. We helped her with a sign. It was still interesting to see. Monument to Baron de Cobin, considered father of the modern Olympics. Though he is buried in Lucerne, his heart was placed with this monument in Olympia. We then continued our stroll with views of Olympia. A nice little town with a tree to celebrate Christmas. The station is quite central. We then returned to Katakalon with time to explore. Just a small town with its main street and a very pleasant waterfront. Yoga time. Fantasia is both close to town and an easy stroll. After an enjoyable day, we set sail. From the port, we took the train into the city centre. I fell in love with Athens in my early 20s and keep coming back. It's like a second home. For me, this hill provides some of the best pictures of the Acropolis. The monument built by the Athenians was completed in AD 119. Yoga. A bit of nostalgia. I have a picture stood here about 50 years ago. Great thing wandering around Athens, you always have something to see. Christmas in Syntagma, it was alive. The Parliament building in the background. A glass of of nice Greek wine ends a beautiful day. A place I like and know quite well, I planned the day to stay within the city. Rhodes and the medieval old town is a beautiful place. It's lovely to walk along the waterfront. Historically, Colossus, one of the seven wonders of the world, is said to have stood with his feet across the entrance of the harbour. For me, it's a place of memories, as I used to swim from the beach here and have cold beers. The newer part of town has got some interesting buildings. Built from antiquity to the 16th century. I guess better known for the Knights of St. John around 1309. It really is a wonderful place to explore. The wonderful thing about the medieval town, set within the castle, it is alive. People live within the houses, there are shops, restaurants. It's a magic place. One should just walk and explore. The avenue of the knights is wonderful, as you will see the coats of arms of the various knights on the walls. We were lucky, we found an open door and were able to see the inside of one of the buildings. A coat of arms. One can go inside the palace, it is well worth a visit. After a lot of walking, it was time for a refreshment. After a wonderful day, it was time to head back to the ship. Beautiful views as we leave Rhodes. Never having been to Haifa or Jerusalem, the next couple of days were going to be a big adventure. With a map, we set off to take the funicular up Mount Carmel. Not easy, as firstly we couldn't find the station, and then we didn't know which way to go when we got off. No matter, with a sense of humour and the help of a very pleasant young lady, we found our way. The gardens and the views were spectacular. Disappointing though, one could not explore the gardens from the top. We then set off to try and find the sculpture gardens. Not easy. It was only by luck that we found them. It's a lovely park with 29 sculptures. It's really nice with all the sculptured activities. Again, by luck, we've found another entrance to the gardens. Here, one was allowed in and could explore the grounds. The gardens were beautiful and perfectly kept. Evening was coming in as we walked down from Mount Carmel. Great to see Christmas decorations. The end of an interesting day. A new day, and we travelled to Jerusalem. It's interesting as you travel inland how the countryside changes. I was very excited as I have always wanted to visit Jerusalem. What can I say? Jerusalem from the Mount of Olives. Spectacular. The pictures speak for themselves. We then walked down from the mound into the Kidron Valley, seeing along the way olive trees. Shaped as a teardrop. Thank you. Roman Catholic, also known as the Church of All Nations. A beautiful church, the interior lighting has been kept to a minimum. Some of the olive trees are very old. We had a most enjoyable lunch stop. We continue to the old walled city. I understand this is one of Jerusalem's original streets. The Western Wall, also known as the Wailing Wall. The wall continues within the gates, which also contains a library. The narrow walkways are fascinating. I understand Jesus then continued along Via Dolorosa, as we are. We continued our walk through the narrow streets to Calvary. Church of the Resurrection. For Christians, it marks the crucifixion and burial of Jesus. It is, however, unlike any other church I have seen. Six denominations celebrate their rites within the church. I found the visit very moving. I can't find words to describe the church. Amazing. We then continued our walk through the old town to the Jaffa Gate. To walk down the Mount of Olives and also the Old Town of Jerusalem is something I will always remember. We then had a drive around the modern part of the city before returning to Haifa. We set sail for Crete. Heraklion is a nice town and easy to stroll around. It was, however, a surprise to see snow on the hills. From the port, it's an easy walk downtown. The port is located at the entrance to the old port. Looking towards the city. Outside the city hall, chicken and pork on spits, celebrating Christmas. The main square. Crete's first independent prime minister in 1905. Simple but nice Christmas decoration. Christmas, we join some friends for a most enjoyable lunch. You could ice skate in the main square. Surprise, a Philippine consulate. Old Venetian arches near the waterfront. The end of a lovely day. We took a train from the port to the main station in Rome. Having been to Rome a number of times, we like to just wander the back streets and find the unexpected. Lovely to see the Trevi Fountain again in all its glory. It had been closed for a few months, I guess for renovations. These were areas we had never seen before. An interesting area with many restaurants. At this point we were lost and had to walk back along the Tiber River to find our bearings. Beautiful St. Peter's with its Christmas tree. We then took a train from near the Vatican back to the port with its lovely Christmas decorations. The end of our cruise as we sail for Genoa. It's a nice drive to Nice to join our flight to London. The cruise and service on MSC Fantasia was fantastic. I hope you enjoyed my travels. Neil.